Happy Halloween to all you ghouls and goblins. Today is Saturday, October 31st, and we'll be bringing you this week's news through these cute little Among Us avatars.
We are less than a week away from Election Day, which is November 3rd if you chose to vote absentee. Then you should mail your ballot now because it needs to be received by November 3rd at 12 p.m. If you plan on voting in person, go to indianavoters.in.gov for information such as polling locations and hours. You'll need to bring a valid photo ID and be sure to wear a mask. For all of our viewers who are too young to vote, then encourage your parents to vote and be sure to watch the polling returns Tuesday night and into Wednesday morning. Elections, like a free press, are an essential component of our democracy, and PNN encourages all students to be engaged in the electoral process by voting and watching election returns.
If you are planning on trick-or-treating or taking your siblings, then be sure to mask up and get some good candy. My personal favorite is Twizzlers. If you live in South Bend, then trick-or-treating will take place from 4 to 6 p.m., and if you live in Mishawaka, then it'll be from 5 to 7 p.m. What type of pants do ghosts wear to go trick-or-treating? They wear boo jeans. Get it? Because they're blue jeans, but they're ghosts, and they say boo, so it's boo jeans.
In scary Halloween news, Penn High School has 4 new COVID cases, along with 9,628 in St. Joseph County and 167,000 in Indiana. Wow, now that's scary.
If, instead of doing the monster mash, you're a girl who plays tennis, there is a brief call-out meeting at 8 a.m. on November 11th. It'll take place over Zoom and in room 163. For the Zoom link, you'll scan this QR code and enter the passcode WKPT28. Do you know what sport mummies like? Casketball.
Recycling, climate change, leaves, solar energy, trees, wind, pollution, the greenhouse effect. These are all things that could be talked about during the peak club meeting, but I'm not in the club, so I don't know. They meet during lunch on white days. Their next meeting will be Monday, November 9th at 11:05 a.m., and they'll meet over Zoom because there's nothing scarier than social interaction.
The Republican Club met this morning, so you can't go. But the Writers Guild will meet on Friday, November 6th, so you can go to that from 3:30 to 4:30. Email cmorton@phm.k12.in.us for more details.
What's scarier than Indiana weather? Nothing! Now to Gavin with weather.
Hello, Penn. I am your PNN weatherman, Gavin, for this week's spooky weather. First off, there will be a blue moon on Halloween night. A blue moon is a rare instance in which there are two full moons in a single month. The last blue moon was on March 31st, 2018, the weather everyone cares about. The weather for Halloween night will be a high of 51 and a low of 40. Scary, right? Wear a coat or don't. I'm not your mom.
Do you need an extra hour of sleep? Well, I do. After you're all done with all your Halloween festivities, at 2 a.m. on November 1st, you'll fall back 1 hour, making it 1 a.m. on November 1st.
You know what's not scary? Kindness. People should be scared of how kind you are. If you need some guidance on being kind, then join the Random Acts of Kindness Club. They'll meet virtually on November 2nd at 3:15 p.m. Email Senora Brasso for more details.
The yearbook editors are looking for some feature images. If you have any summer images of you, with your pets, by your friends, or by yourself, email them to Brannigan Thomas at bthomas066@phm.k12.in.us. Be sure to include your name, grade level, and a short summary of what you were doing. If you have any spooky dooky fall images, email them to Paige Parker at pparker753@phm.k12.in.us. Also be sure to include your name, grade level, and a brief description of what you were doing.
That looks like all the scariness we have for you. Oh wait, why did the Scarecrow get an award at work? That's what I thought. It's because he was outstanding in his field. Now don't forget to be safe this Halloween and to scare the candy out of your siblings.
And don't feed your dog any chocolate. Bye for now, but stay tuned for sports.
Following a successful semi-state, boys and girls cross country are both going to state. The boys placed 6th and had 3 runners in the top 50. At 47th, Ben Bordley with a time of 16 minutes and 46 seconds. Dylan Potchman at 35th with a time of 16 minutes and 38 seconds. And Mariano Retzloff placing 2nd with a time of 15 minutes and 34 seconds. The girls had 3 of their own runners in the top 50. Ava Gillis placing 40th with a time of 20 minutes and 9 seconds. Mary Eubank finishing 8 seconds earlier, placing 36th and running a time of 20 minutes and 9 seconds. And Julie Smith placing 14th with a time of 19 minutes and 16 seconds. Nice job, cross country. The Penn volleyball team saw its season end for the 2nd straight year with a heartbreaking loss. Number 3 Crown Point outlasted the number 12 Kingsman 3-2 in a semifinal match in the Class 4A LaPorte Regional. Lisa Pollock's Penn squad finished the year with 29 wins and 6 losses. Crown Point, now with 30 wins and 3 losses, beat the Kingsman 25-23. They lost 23-25. They won 26-24. They lost 13-25, and they won 15-11. Emma Hickey had a stellar night with 29 kills, 30 digs, 2 aces, and 3 blocks. Cadence McLaughlin had 21 digs, and Macy Hackovich had 9 kills, 2 blocks, and 53 assists. The Penn football team is coming off a bye week last Friday and will take on Chesterton at 7:30. This will be an away game for the Kingsmen.
As we all know, athletes are switching over to virtual or online education. I got an interview with Colin Fleming, a Penn High School swimmer, with more information about what exactly is going on.
As COVID continues to be a huge problem in our daily lives, some Penn High School student athletes are starting to go virtual after being in hybrid school learning. A Penn High School swimmer, Colin Fleming, is one of those athletes participating in this decision. We decided to get an interview with him to better understand why athletes are going to virtual learning.
So I think most of all athletes wanted to test out how hybrid learning was going and how it would work. And I think once they saw it in 2 days a week, they wanted to switch to virtual just to be more safe, especially for the winter athletes, how their season's coming up, and just to be more safe and not get contact traced.
Since a lot of athletes are going virtual, it has caused many concerns for coaches and families, knowing the COVID numbers are going up again and how dangerous it would be for athletes. Colin's family was one of those families with reasons he was going virtual.
So there are 2 main reasons that our family chose for us to go virtual. Is one of them is the flu and COVID. We don't think we'll mix well. And second is contact tracing. And we know contact tracing, you'll be out of school for 14 days. And for me, I'll be out of the pool for 14 days. And I don't really want that to happen to me.
Even though he is going virtual, he does believe here at Penn, school is safe. He believes that Penn has set up great guidelines, and they are just taking the extra precautions by going virtual.
I like the guidelines that Penn and Penn Athletics have brought down, but yeah, I feel safe at Penn.
To all sport athletes that are staying hybrid and participating in sports, still have to stay safe during COVID. During swimming, Colin talks about how they keep everyone safe by following the rules and guidelines.
So what we've done at pool deck is we always stretch before practice. So we always keep our masks on before practice while we're stretching and all that. And even before we get behind the blocks, we have our masks on, and then like say 30 seconds before we get in, we'll take it off and get in the pool. And another thing we've done is we used to have like 4 or 5 people on one side of the wall. And now we have 2 people on one side, 2 people on the other, socially distanced throughout those 2 people. So our coach has done a really good job setting those guidelines and make sure we keep social distance. So,
thanks everyone for watching. Now back to you.
Thank you, Colin, for taking your time to talk to us. Make sure to follow us on social media at Penn News Network, and make sure to be safe this Halloween. Have a good weekend, Kingsmen.